basically are embedded in this constant flow of images or constant flow of information. It's a sort of osmosis between the online and the offline that is constantly affecting you. Instagram started to give a sense of authenticity, to really take pictures of life and real things and so on, and then they became something completely artificial. There is a sense of permanent voyeurism, permanent need to go behind the scenes, an obsession to unveil what are the mechanics behind the project, so not just the final output.
That instant aspect of image making today, and that it is used as something that you can see very quickly and then it's gone. Whereas architecture is not really gone then, because the building still stands there. But there is not so much discussion anymore about that what you show in the image of architecture, what the building is doing behind that image of architecture and how it works and what kind of spatial organizational effects are to be found. That is maybe the tricky aspect of Instagram world, that we have to make sure that we are not becoming too much one-off architects.
Instagram and social media is part of our idea for the platform of the post-occupancy analysis, so we don't have to capture information about the quality of the space only from our measurements of sensors or interviews with the users. We look at social media, at images that people post. How do they actually appropriate the spaces that are oftentimes different than what we imagined it to be? For example, Arnhem Central images on Instagram. This is a train station that all of a sudden is being used for dance performances, for music concerts, or beyond just an address in the city to meet or to take a train from.
The more a building is capable of engaging somehow the visitors beyond the program that it's meant to solve, at least from a certain point of view, the more it is successful today. It is particularly true for temporary architecture that AMO does in general, either if it's an exhibition or a set that is meant to be temporary. So there, the image becomes more important. It's not anymore that theatrical, it's not anymore a snap, but it's an intimate experience of a person being there at an event or visiting a place.
Social media unveils a new side of the communication of architecture. It's really about people experiencing and doing things in a building, rather than taking the good photos that you would see in an architectural magazine. We see this duality in the website, the more architectural point of view, but then next to it you have also a lot of different personal experience. It creates a more complete view of what it is, engagement or involvement with the social side of architecture.
Everyone produces images. The whole landscape has democratized. People want to see where things come from, how things are made. The storytelling in projects is becoming more and more important. It's really a matter of how do you curate it and how do you quantify and qualify what's on the image. Normally when people present themselves in a certain building on Instagram, it's a place where people want to be seen. And also the engagement with the image tells a story about how they use the space and how we can improve the space.